Hello, this is Bern, and if you're a single woman, you either are falling for or have fallen for these three false choices. And what I want to do right now is explain to you what they are so you never have to fall prey to them and can actually get the love that you want. So stick around. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your great life2be.com. Today's another edition of Get the Love You Crave, and what I'll be sharing with you right now is three erroneous choices that women feel they have to make, and because of that, have such a hard time finding the love they want. Because when you tell your brain that something is happening, your brain tends to believe it. And if you step into it in a way that reinforces it, then you keep finding more of the same, and your brain says, well, see, I told you that's what it is. So the first one is the guys that I want, the amazing, conscious, masculine, has his finances in order, is not a mama's boy, he is pursuing women that, the right way, that type of guy doesn't want me. Here's the challenge when you believe that. And sometimes it's true, maybe one of those guys that you connect with doesn't want you, but whenever you find that that's the case in your life, most likely, you keep showing up in a very specific way that does not allow the kind of guy you want to get to know you, to get to see you, to feel hunger for you. So you almost, once this belief develops, next time you show up against a guy like that, instead of showing up free, unattached, flowing, feminine, amazing, you show up with this whole fear of what the hell does he think of me? And with that type of stance, you show up clumsy, or you show up with less energy, or you show up with a less intense and carefree vibration, and the woman he meets is not you, is the you who's scared, the you who's not in her feminine, or the you who's not in her aliveness, right? So number two is the guys that I want don't want me, but of the ones who do want me, there's only two choices. A guy who is exciting, but bad for me. For example, the guy who's a bad boy, the guy who's emotionally available, the guy who is a smooth talker, but doesn't want necessarily longer term relationship, the guy who's great at getting you to feel excited and maybe wants to take you to bed, but doesn't really want to have something meaningful the next morning. Women feel that either the guy they want doesn't want them, or they have this exciting but bad boy, which is basically good for nothing, other than just feeling good for a little bit. Or number three, they have the option of connecting to a good guy who's boring, no edge, no chemistry, a good friendship, but more like a roommate type of relationship. So here's the challenge in buying into this bullshit. The more you buy into it, the harder it is to see reality the way it is. Okay, if you, as I mentioned before, if you put on your very dark sunglasses and you step out into beautiful day and you think everything is dark because your sunglasses are on, then well, that's take off the sunglasses, right? Now here's the reason why most women cannot take off the freaking sunglasses and actually see the reality, which is much more than these three choices. Because the reason why you believe that guys don't want you, or that only guys that you have are exciting but bad for you, or are maybe good guys for you but no chemistry, is because if you were to actually get what you wanted, you would be faced with a deeper level of fear and insecurity and problem that, even though rationally doesn't make sense, irrationally it feels a lot scarier than the comfort that you've been accustomed to. So in other words, one of my mentors, a guy I really admire, said to me once, most problems in life are an addiction to the payoff. Let me repeat it. Most problems in life, you can repeat that, most problems in love are an addiction to the payoff. So if the payoff you're getting by not finding the guy is you don't have to risk, you don't have to be abandoned, you don't have to get your heart broken, you don't have to be physically naked in front of someone, you don't have to be emotionally and spiritually naked in front of someone, or worse, you don't have to be seen completely and then find out that when somebody sees you for all you are, then he doesn't want you. As long as you continue facing those three false choices, you never have to experience the depth of pain that would result if you took a bigger risk. So the answer to the three dilemmas that I'm putting here right now is not necessarily better dating techniques, but to figure out what is your payoff. And that's where I want to leave it today. I want for you to think today, start the process of thinking, what's the payoff? I know that it sounds like rationally it doesn't make sense, but if I did have a payoff for not finding the kind of love that I want, what is it? What am I avoiding? What am I gaining by staying stuck? What am I gaining by having this kind of existence where I don't have to experience the deepest level of intimacy with someone? Hope this is helpful, insightful, and useful in some way. If it is, I'm gonna ask you to do three things. Number one, click like on this video. Number two, subscribe to my channel. Number three, on the description of this video, you will see a link or somewhere on your page here that takes you to a page. All you have to do is click on the yellow bar on that page and then click on the enter your name and email, and you'll be able to watch a 41-minute presentation that I created for you that will share with you how you can create the kind of relationship you want and find your soulmate far faster than your current trajectory. And if you have any questions for me, any comments on this, place them on the comment on this video. I look forward to connecting with you. And as always, I challenge you to live a full, conscious life.